Hey, the first letter I ever got published was in the Financial Times, and I was comparing my art to Lucian Freud's. It was about women, how we are seen, the fact that globally we are still lagging behind men in terms of economic power and basic human rights. This was several years ago, and who knew I'd firsthand, in your face, have to experience it. But for anyone that has come and listened to my YouTubes and really supported me, I want to thank you, because women are judged so much more harshly. We're weighed, we're judged, and we're told we don't measure up. And it's ironic because now men are getting some of that treatment that we have been. And because I'm not blonde, I haven't thinned my eyebrows, thinned out my nose, and spent all my time dieting, there are many people that won't give me the time of day. And women, we're blamed for everything. We're blamed for, if we're murdered, we're blamed for the murder. Somehow it's our fault. If we're raped, it's somehow our fault. If men harass us, it's somehow our fault because of the way we dressed or because we dare to open our mouths. We're supposed to be Barbies and keep our mouths shut. So one, I want to thank the Financial Times way back when for giving me the time of day, for giving me a platform to speak up as a woman, as an artist, about women and basic human rights, economic, you name it. Thank you, Financial Times, for being the first person to open the door and let me have a say as a person, not as somebody servile, you know, coming in and doing my you know, everything I've done, all these jobs that they weren't fun, but as an artist and a person, I got to speak up in the Financial Times, my first letter, and that meant a lot to me. Yeah, that.